Okay, day 13 on the cart. It's back day. We're in here. Tough day at uni today, doing my master's degree. I had a fucking long day, but I'm in here 9:30, getting in snatch grip deadlifts as my first exercise. I'm going to do 4 sets of 7 with a pause on the 1st, 4th, and 6th rep. A 3 to 5 second pause below the knee on the way up on the 1st, 4th, and 6th rep. 3 to 5 seconds, which makes it way harder. And I'm doing snatch grip, which makes it even harder. I'm doing 175 kilo, 4x7, 4 sets of 7. This is my second set now. Let's get it. Let's get straight into it. I don't know why, but those are feeling easier than last week. My cardiovascular is slowly improving again, especially when you're going high rep on deads. Someone was laughing behind the camera when I said that. When you're going high rep on deads, cardiovascular endurance is very important. And when I was peak bulk, I had zero of that. And it's slowly coming back, and I'm finding high rep deadlift sets above like 5 reps a lot easier. So yeah, feeling good. I'm up 5 kilo from last week. Did 170 last week, 175 this week. So slowly adding weight on the cut, which is good. It's only the early stages of the cut. On deadlift, you can hang on to strength a lot easier than pressing movements. Actually, even increase it when you cut in the early stages. Whereas pressing movements, you can't do that. Anyway, I'll do 2 more sets here, then move on to the next exercise. Okay, next exercise, we're on to body weight pull-ups. I am reintroducing pull-ups on the cut. I didn't do that many pull-ups on the bulk. Obviously, when you're bulking, it's very, very hard to maintain pull-up strength, so I don't really do too many pull-ups on the bulk. But now that I'm cutting, it's a movement. It's one of the few movements that you can really increase in strength. It's a lot easier to do pull-ups when you're lighter than when you're heavy. So I did pull-ups for the first week of the cut last week, just body weight. Again, this week, it's the second week of me doing pull-ups on the cut. Again, just body weight, working my way back into it. I'm gonna do 10 minutes, as many reps as I can get in 10 minutes. So how many, I'll do a couple sets in that 10 minute period, see how many reps I can get. I'm waiting for the clock to hit the next minute and then I'm gonna start. All right, let's go. Okay, 9 reps that first set. I'll take a little rest, then do another set and another set, see how many I can get in 10 minutes. I won't film at all. I've got 9 reps on my first set. Okay, next exercise, we're going to do a one-arm row. This is a thickness exercise. This is a heavy thickness exercise. This is my main rowing movement for the workout. I'm going to do just 2 sets of 10 on each side. I'm going quite heavy, and that's all I need. I'm doing a lot of volume this workout. This is my third exercise. I'm doing 5 exercises. So all I need really is 2 sets of 10 each side, very, very heavy, to get in that heavy rowing movement. I try and get in at least 1 heavy row movement and then 1 lighter row movement, like a cable row as well, a workout. So 2 row movements, 1 heavy, 1 more of a cable. And this is obviously the heavy row movement that I'm incorporating into my back workout. I think heavy rows, deadlifts and heavy rows are so important for back thickness. Pull-ups are great for width, but if you're not doing some kind of heavy row, your back's not going to be as thick as it could be. So on the bulk, I did a lot of barbell rows. On the cut now, I'm changing it. I'm doing a lot of one-arm dumbbell rows, which are great for thickness. Bloody hell, those are tough. Those are tough. Ooh. When you do one-arm dumbbell rows, I like to do them slightly elevated, not on a flat bench. Do them on an incline bench. That way, I can get into a better position. When the bench is too flat, I struggle to connect with my lats, and I feel it more in the rear delts. So elevate the bench slightly and try and row that dumbbell into your pocket, elbow to pocket, really move it back, drive it back and try and hit those lats. Fourth exercise, we're back on pull downs. We're doing a traditional conventional lat pull down. We're gonna do 3 sets, 8 to 12 reps. I've done my first set already. This is the most basic, pretty much the most basic pull down you can do, other than pull-ups. You think of a traditional lat pull down, an age-old lat pull down. This is it. There's so many different handle attachments and cable attachments you can put in and different bars. This is the most traditional, old school. And I'll mix the bar around occasionally, but I'll always go back to this bar. It's the bread and butter. This old school lat pull down bar. you see all the golden age bodybuilders using this bar. So sometimes I'll switch it up and go for a neutral grip bar for a few weeks and months, but I'll always return back to this. I'll always return back to the basics. Sometimes you want to sway away from the basics for a couple of weeks, but then always return back to them. Always keep the staples in. Every couple months, come back to them. Those staples should always be there. You might want to go away from the staple, a staple movement for a while. Instead of doing a normal squat, do a box squat for a while. But I always come back to squats, if you know what I mean. So this is a staple movement I always come back to. This is my second set. Let's talk a little bit about mindset. Mindset is everything in this game. You've got to love this game. It's 11 o'clock on a Tuesday. How many guys are doing this? How many guys are intentionally forcing themselves to suffer? I don't want to be another guy, man. I don't want to go through my life with an average fucking physique, with hardly any muscle. You know how depressing that is? Just walk down the street, go on the tube in London or the subway in America and just sit down for an hour and look at people. 99% of people you see are fucking out of shape. They're not bulking, they're not cutting, they're not doing anything. They're not trying to improve their physique, they're not in the gym, they're not working hard. You got one physique, one body. Carve it, create a masterpiece. Create a masterpiece. Okay, final back movement. I'm gonna finish with a V-handle cable row. Again, 3 sets of 8 to 12 reps. I don't always count the reps, but this is my final exercise on back. Second set. Let's go, baby, come on. Everything I got, come on. Tom Platz said something back in the day that I truly resonate with. He said, every workout, think of it as a sponge, and you're trying to drain every single drop of water out of that sponge as possible. You come in the gym, and you shouldn't leave the gym unless you've drained every single drop of water from that sponge, unless you've given everything you have. Give absolutely everything you've got. Leave nothing on the fucking table. Okay. The workout's not finished yet because I am gonna end on abs. Okay, ladies, final exercise. Finishing off with abs. I'm gonna do 2 sets of 20 to 30 seconds each side, Copenhagen side planks, which is basically when both feet are raised, one's on top, one's underneath it here. Both feet are raised, very, very difficult, very challenging, a lot harder than a normal side plank. This is my second and final set. I'm exhausted. Let's get this workout finished. Come on, baby. All right, that's the workout. All glory to God, as always. Nick Hijazi, the founder of the Mendez Cartel, the Natty King. Subscribe to this channel. Follow me on Instagram and TikTok. And as always, long live King Charles III, and God bless Sir Winston Churchill.